At home, away from the group, there are other aspects of adolescent behavior that are annoying to parents. There's the untidiness. The eternal hunger, picking at whatever is around to eat. It's certainly annoying to mother, who has plans for what is to be eaten and when. But the universal appearance of these adolescent traits leads to the conclusion that they are normal and based on real needs. Kay is quite mature for her age. She's well adjusted, accepting her defects and trying to make the most of her assets. She's tremendously influenced by fashion advertisements and gets many ideas on grooming from magazines, television, and movies. To wear her hair and clothes according to the latest style is much more important than to wear them in the most becoming way. She's not mature enough yet to rely on her own judgment. The world knows best, and she wants to be sure of her place in the world. Mother may have other opinions of what looks best, but of course, mother has old-fashioned ideas. Kay's mother is always a little overwhelmed at the extremes to which her suddenly grown-up daughter carries her ideas of style. If it's the style to be careless and informal, her sloppiness is so deliberate as to be offensive. But mother has learned that these things are usually temporary. The less said about them, the more quickly they wear off. Objection often brings friction without any change. Half an hour after she has left her friends, she's on the phone to them again.
Hello, is Joni there?
It seems unnecessary, but there's a real need for talking to others in the same stage, for constant reassurance of her standing as friend and equal.
Hello, Joni. Look, I've got an idea. Why don't we go down to Johnson's after supper? Maybe some of the gang will be there and we can cook up something.
Gee, Kay, I'm awful sorry. I can't go. I have to stay home tonight. Well, why don't you ask Sally? Maybe she can go. Okay, I'm awful
Joan
sorry.
Joan is not as independent as Kay is, perhaps because she hasn't been encouraged to stand on her own feet. There is no friction in Joan's family life. Her mother finds her a very good girl. Headstrong and flighty like so many of her friends seem to be. She takes her schoolwork seriously, perhaps too seriously. She has high standards for herself, and if she falls below them, her insecurity and worry are increased. Joan seems to be coming quietly through these difficult years, but the stress and strain are there and result in an almost complete withdrawal from people. She does a lot of daydreaming, imagining herself as the extrovert that she is not. She goes over and over little events in her life, reliving her successes and suffering through her failures all over again. Joan doesn't have emotional outbursts. Her safety valve is her diary. Here, she is herself, letting off emotional steam and clarifying her thoughts about growing up.